which is tough enough to contain this variant. That means the government is once again instructing you to stay at home.
2020 was a bad year for everybody. It forced us to spend most of our year indoors and in lockdown conditions. Our only escape was our daily exercise and walks. But if the pandemic has taught us anything, it's how much we need nature and the space it gives us to think. During the lockdown, I found myself daydreaming about Dartmoor, and it gave me an idea for a new film. Dartmoor is renowned for its open spaces and sweeping panoramic views. Much less known are the hidden woodlands nestled in the gorges and the valleys to the east. So I decided to make a film about Dartmoor's hidden forests and why they are so special. Dartmoor National Park is a large granite upland plateau in the county of Devon. It dominates the skyline in many areas of the county, and at 621 metres is the highest point in England south of the Peak District. It's famous for its wide open moorland landscapes, expansive views and rugged granite tors that rise suddenly out of the plateau. There's so much more to the park than moorland. If you know where to look, the park is littered with beautiful hay meadows, valley mires, and steep wooded valleys. One of the scarcest habitats on Dartmoor is woodland. Only 12% of the park is woodland, and of that, only 30% of it is ancient woodland. Ancient woodland is one of the most biodiverse habitats in the British Isles, and also one of the rarest. Millenniums of deforestation have reduced ancient woodland cover in the British Isles to just 2.5% of its original cover. In prehistoric times, Dartmoor would have been predominantly covered in forest, with patches of open grass and a blanket bog existing on higher elevations. Today, the moor is heavily grazed by cattle, sheep and Dartmoor ponies, and this keeps the landscape bare and open, preventing young trees from naturally recolonising the moor. The remaining woodland areas on Dartmoor are fantastic places to see wildlife, go on long walks, and even stargaze and watch shooting stars streak across the sky. The reason I've made this film is to show a side of Dartmoor that so often goes unnoticed, next to the backdrop of vast, open landscapes. The first woodland in this film is nestled in a steep river valley a few miles into the national park boundary. In the spring, the forest is full of life. Birdsong fills the air and wood ant nests litter the forest floor. By May, flowers carpet the understory and the forest comes alive with colour. Wild garlic, bluebells, early purple orchid and red campion all grow in abundance. By late summer, the moths, butterflies and bees appear and bring a further dash of colour to an otherwise green landscape. Virtually all the wooded valleys on Dartmoor have rivers running through them, and these rivers are ultimately responsible for carving out the valleys in the first place. The woodland clings to the sides of the valley, and the trees are covered in lichens and mosses, which are indicators of clean air. The trees are predominantly oak, some rowan, ash, holly and beech scattered through the valley. But the true draw of this river for me is the wild swimming. On a sunny day, taking a dip and sunbathing on the warm granite rocks is pure bliss. Whilst Dartmoor is stunning in the sunshine, more often than not, the moors are very, very wet. The settlement of Princetown, towards the centre of the moor, receives 2 metres of rain a year. The moors are actually so wet that a lot of the woodlands are classed as temperate Atlantic rainforest, and after rainfall, they can feel extremely humid. During the spring and the summer, sudden and intense thundery downpours can affect the moor, and it really does feel like you're walking through a rainforest. Another such fragment of temperate rainforest can be found towards the southwest of the moor. It's characterised by gnarled oaks with huge granite boulders and sheer cliff faces. It's a popular spot with climbers due to the exposed crags and variety of climbing routes. Standing on the edges of the cliffs is a stomach-churning experience, as some of the cliffs drop vertically by about 30 to 40 metres. But it's a stunning place to go for a walk and a wild swim when the river is a bit calmer than it is on this day. Thank you. Good afternoon from a very hot, sweaty, sticky, humid Dartmoor. It's about 30 degrees today. I think the Met Office have issued an extreme heat warning for the southwest. But I'm going on a spectacular walk on the south of the moor today. You can see sort of the high moorland in the background in the valley in which the woodland I'm going to visit is in. I can see all the way down to Plymouth Sound down that way and then to the south coast further down that way. This woodland is probably, yeah, it's pretty secluded. It's a lovely oak woodland. And I'm not going to say exactly where it is, just because it gets a lot of heavy footfall traffic and it probably doesn't need that many more visitors, but if you can work out where it is, it's a beautiful spot. And I'm hoping that I'm not going to melt on the way there today. Many of the forests on Dartmoor are mere shadows of what they used to be. The creation of woodland would not only help reduce carbon dioxide, but also provide habitat for hundreds of species that are currently limited to the remaining fragments of forest. If you want to support the creation of woodland on Dartmoor and across Devon, have a look at charities such as More Trees and Devon Wildlife Trust.